Debenture means borrowed capital. Debenture is a document issued under the common seal of a company for raising debt and acknowledging the debt. The interest on debt raised through debenture is paid at a predetermined rate. For this, companies create a floating charge on the assets of the company. When joint stock companies need capital for a long time period, they issue shares or debentures to raise the capital. According to Sir Francis Palmer, debenture is a type of a document issued under the common seal of the company acknowledging the debt. Debenture is a document issued under the common seal of the company acknowledging the debt of a specified amount, in which till the principal amount is repaid, interest at specified rate is payable under the contract, a charge is created on the assets of the company. So we can say a relationship of debtor and creditor is created between the company and the debenture holder. A joint stock company issues debentures for a long-term capital investment, but debenture holder does not get a right to vote in the company, nor he can participate in the management. But to safeguard the interest, the debenture holder can appoint debenture trustee. As the company goes into liquidation, at first the debenture holders are paid the money by selling the assets of the company. Let us learn types of debenture. The types of debenture are mortgage debenture, fully convertible debenture, FCD, partly convertible debenture, PCD, and non-convertible debenture, NCD. So let us learn the first one, mortgaging debenture. When company issues this type of debenture, it creates a charge on the assets of the company. This charge can be fixed or floating charge. When fixed charge is created, the company cannot dispose of the mortgaged assets without the permission of the trustee. That is the trustees formed by the debenture. When floating charge is created, company can use its assets in any way it likes. But when the company makes default in paying interest or any installment, the floating charge becomes the fixed charge. So at the time of liquidation, the debenture holder have the first right on the assets of the company. Fully convertible debenture. Simply it means that these debenture can be fully converted into shares. Once the agreement specified period is completed, these debentures can be converted into equity shares. Now the company gives two options to the holder: to redeem the debenture or to take equity share of the same amount. If the debenture holder opts for fully convertible debenture, then his rights as creditor come to an end and he gets rights as equity shareholder. Second is partially convertible debenture. Here the debentures can be converted into equity share only partly, and the unconvertible debenture remains as such. So equity shares are issued against the convertible part while the non-convertible part is redeemed. Third is non-convertible debenture. These debentures are not converted into equity shares. The holders are paid their money back by redemption at the end of the specified time period. Procedure of issue of debenture. There are specific provisions in the Indian Companies Act for issue of a debenture. It is necessary to mention all the provision at the time of issuing the debenture. If something goes wrong, then the concerned officer will be liable for punishment. It is necessary to ensure that there is no risk or danger to the interest of debenture holder. First is resolution by board of directors. The provision of debentures of the articles of company are studied, then a resolution is passed in the meeting of board of directors to issue the debenture. At this meeting, a decision is taken about the total issue, rate of interest, payment of interest, number of debenture certificates and conditions. Resolution by general meeting of the company. Here the sanction of issue of debenture is obtained in the general meeting of the company if, due to issue of debenture, the debt of company exceeds free reserves of the company, or if the debenture are to be issued for an amount exceeding free reserve fund, then the approval of the member is to be obtained by conveying the general meeting of members. Third is permission of SEBI. It is necessary to ensure that the provision of the Companies Act and guidelines and permission from SEBI is obtained. SEBI full form is Securities and Exchange Board of India. Fourth is to issue prospectus. public limited company invites general public to subscribe debentures by issuing prospectus, which describes the content of debenture. Here, investor studies it and takes a decision to purchase the debenture. Fifth, appointment of trustees for debentures. In order to safeguard interest of debenture holder, a trust deed, debenture trust deed, is prepared under the Trust Act. Trustee for debentures are appointed in the company. Sixth, agreement with underwriters. If the board of directors decides to enter into an agreement with underwriters for the issue of debenture, it is done at this stage. The conditions are determined for both parties. To open an account with a scheduled bank. Here, the account is opened at the scheduled bank to receive application and money for debenture. Eighth, registration in stock exchange. If it is so stated in the prospectus, the company has to apply to a recognized stock exchange so that the listing of debentures can be done and the debentures can be traded in the market. Now, if they refuses to register or cancels the registration of debenture issue, the company has to pay back the money to the debenture holder. Ninth, to prepare allotment register for debenture. After the closure of subscription, as specified in the prospectus, now the secretary, that is the company secretary, has to prepare a register so that they can write down all those application which has been received. Now, the allotment of debenture is to be taken once in the meeting of the board of director, the decision is been done, how much to be allotted. The process of remittance of debenture certificate is commenced. 10th, debenture certificate. If the subscription to the debenture is to be made through part payment of debenture money, then after receiving the full amount towards the debentures allotted, the company secretary prepares debenture certificate and, in accordance with the provision of the Companies Act, dispatchment of certificate to debenture holder is been done. The various rights of debenture holders are: right to receive interest at the specified time and rate, get back the money invested on the date of maturity, to examine and study the document at the registered office, to obtain information by depositing the requisite fee. The company prepare a trust deed with debenture holder, so they have a right to be informed that functioning is conducted according to the provision of the deed. Right to appoint debenture trustee to safeguard their interest. The board of director have to take into confidence the debenture trustee before making any important decision. To ensure the property mortgaged under the trust deed. Right to initiate legal action if the condition or the provision of trust deed in respect of property under security are not complied with. Right to receive report regarding the progress and development of the company at irregular intervals. Right to receive their money back on priority basis at the time of liquidation of the company.